Hasselhoff? You were robbed. Everyone knows it. But you know what? Sitting around feeling sorry for yourself won't change anything. You gotta get back out there. You gotta show them the real Hoff.
Eddie is looking like Happy Feet the Penguin.
But Ruby, have the champagne ready.
I'm guessing things are on the up and up if you are starting to notice similar patterns that are becoming quite occurrent on this show. Yeah, high times out on the sea, champagne flowing, Cort getting into more mischief.
Huh? Did I tell you or what?
Oh my God, whoa!
It's almost as if NBC threw out the lifeguard concept.
Let's have some fun.
So Cort convinces Eddie and Shawnee and her meal ticket of the evening that we will never see again to embark on an illegal offshore casino.
This is it? We're going aboard this rust bucket?
Come on, all this thing needs is a couple of coats of paint.
All located in this little dinghy. I think you're going to need a bigger boat.
Trust me.
Cort, what is up with your date? She has the personality and mannerisms of an Austin Powers fembot.
And here? Here you go.
There's a Studebaker running.
It's the password. You gotta keep the riffraff out. You know?
Disgusting.
WCAQ. Back at the Buchanan household, Mitch knows best by grilling about frozen food.
Dad, you're insulting me.
Why? What's wrong with these?
Mitch is not always the gourmet he claims to be, but when he does, he takes the box out of the trash to read the directions.
Absolutely right.
So you're telling me you buy cooked frozen food to cook it again?
Absolutely right.
They say frozen food is high in cholesterol, but in Mitch's case, he just stares at the frozen box a few seconds before he eats it.
Good one, Dad.
After their deal a meal, Mitch leaves Hobie to take care of himself at home while he continues to sex instruction from Hobie's teacher, Mrs. Haddington.
You're right.
Where his first lesson is for free.
It's your future we're talking about. You don't have that many good years left.
So tonight better be a very good date.
Do I do go
Hello there, Stevie Wonder, old naughty, now this is Terrence Alexander Young. Hello to Mayfair, the Tudor Street gang, man. Rock and steady on your hotspot hangout radio station for your Monday night.
WCAU-FM. Well, after feeling his luck is going to change, Eddie is stricken with a gambling problem that leaves him with thousands of dollars worth of debt.
Yeah.
Place your bet. Red 14.
It is both expected for him being such a sucker.
Come on, money.
Yeah.
Here's where I think gambling addiction hotlines would do so much better if every fifth caller was a winner.
One of those markers, please.
How much do you want it for?
1,000. Make it 2,000.
However, we find out that those operating this casino don't take too kindly to those who dishonor their debts.
I always make good on my debts. I mean, you told Mr. Donvier that, didn't you?
You missed a payment. He's very upset. Sorry, Jay. No second chances.
They say a carefully chosen, sorry I can't pay my gambling debt card can help soften the blow. Meanwhile, Casa de Buchanan, Hobie's teacher, spends the night with Mitch.
You're up early.
See, he is learning already. You see, sex is like math. You add the bed, subtract the clothes, divide the legs, and pray you don't multiply.
I'm all yours.
The Hoff always suffers from his presumed irresistible sex appeal, and Hobie is cashing in on his dad putting in a good word for him, so as a result, he thinks he is off scot-free from his school assignments.
When are you the genius brain who doesn't need to do his homework? Since my dad started dating Miss Keller. Slip off your homework? What a rough break for you, Ho.
WCAU.
Johnny gets angry that Eddie arrived late at home, which leaves him to go out on the picnic alone.
Sorry I'm late.
Did you have a nice boat ride?
It's very long. And I'm ready for our picnic.
Good. Just bring the basket back when you're through.
That's okay, Eddie. For they say lunch is a time when it's okay to play with your meat.
Shawnee.
You gotta be clear tonight. Low down to 63, man. Sunny more humid tomorrow, man. Basically mild and wild. Whoa! Yeah, like it. High tomorrow gonna be 88. Winds are southwest at 4 miles an hour. Wind humidity 56%. Temperature is 71. Ocean water temperature to the shore is 66.
WCAU-FM. Mitch and his adorable girlfriend are having their montage moment running down the beach with their sweaters. I haven't seen a montage moment that screams it isn't easy being cheesy. Nor have I eyewitnessed a man feeling so like The Walking Dead to eat someone's face off.
Yeah.
Either that or I consider this montage a metaphor for runaway consumerism.
Yeah.
They say laughter is the best medicine, but if you're overly excessively laughing your ass at this montage for no reason.
I want some of your brochures.
All you need to do is kick up the montage jam and I swear it will be almost as if she was stalked. No, I mean the Hoff having an intense research of an individual on stalker camp. Then again, it will only be two more episodes before she is never seen again. She blocked you, Mitch. Time for Mitch to make a new profile and step up his game.
Listen, yo.
I want some of your brochure.
WCAU. inside Cort's wardrobe shack, he has Sport pretending to threaten Eddie with a gun. He came, he saw, he forgot what he was doing. That's the useless power of Eddie.
What are you trying to do? Scare me to death, huh?
Would I do that?
Where are we going with this? Are you fucking with us, Baywatch? Because at this point, most degenerate gamblers get themselves in so deep that they end up losing 3 times as much money in their bank account that they won.
What's that? Oh, I can tell you how to beat the casinos at their own game.
How?
Don't play? Only an idiot thinks you're gonna make money gambling.
Most guys get so greedy that they wind up losing 3 times as much money as they won.
Fools.
That they would charge anyone to blow them for luck.
Yeah.
So in order to get himself even, he goes to the most likely accessible source by borrowing money from Cort.
I owe you.
Eddie finds his way back to the casino and loses the borrowed money again, and this time the mob wants their fucking money.
Mr. Kramer, I'm surprised to see you here.
Hey.
When I heard you were on board, I assumed you'd come to pay your debts.
I did.
Then I'm sure you won't mind paying what you owe before you finish this hand.
Point, Eddie is looking forward to the apocalypse since it's apparently the only way that he won't have to pay his debts back.
Now that the games are over,
what's more rewarding than an admission of guilt than a weenie smile?
It's time to talk business.
Good. A preferred language is cash.
Could I pay you tomorrow?
Much time as I love to see, I do not get tired of seeing others make Eddie's ass feel humble for the umpteenth time.
It's one thing you don't have to worry about, Mr. Kramer. The boat ride is free.
Hi, good evening.
WCAU.
Battle plan is to go all lawyer mode and claiming if they are running an illegal operation, they will be more easier to shut down.
Before you call Garner, give me a shot at cutting a deal.
Well, we gotta give Eddie some credit, but those mafia interest rates...
20%! No different than most credit cards.
No, that's 20% a week, Eddie. A week. That's what, your $3,000 at the end of the first week is $3,600, the second week it's like, what, four something, the third week it's like five something, right?
Believe me, if you have to ask, you can't afford to play the big.
The picture.
Cort takes Craig's advice to go back to the boat to broker some sort of deal with Snake Eyes.
Snake Eyes. Again?
Not only is it the show's episode title, but it's also how Cort comes to the realization that the casino has been a flawed operation rigging the game.
What, you set me up?
You're out of cash.
$1,000 marker. One bet.
What'll it be?
Why don't you put it on the, don't come line.
Snake Eyes, you win.
Play it to the debt, my friend.
That's the mafia's life for me. Living life as if everything is rigged in your favor.
They cheated me?
Yeah, loaded dice, marked cards, the works.
WCAU-FM.
Hobie's teacher meets back with Mitch and mentions Hobie's poor academic performance and low grades.
We got a problem.
Hobie, I don't like having to defend grades. And I can't play favorites with your son. Hobie's F.
What F?
Mitch is shocked. Why didn't she bring it up in the first place?
His book report, didn't he tell you?
It's the first I've heard about a book report or an F.
Mitch, only responsible for what you say, but not responsible to take initiative on what your son understands.
Well, then I don't get it, because I thought that's why you wanted me to stop by.
I wanted to talk to you about us.
He then explains to his teacher that Hobie has been doing his homework and it's been hard to keep up with things for him.
Hobie's upset about us dating. He came to me yesterday.
Before or after school?
Society sure has gotten to a point where everybody has a right to. A lame excuse, but nobody can take full responsibility for the blame.
No, this has got a lot more to do with it than that.
Well, all I know is that Hobie is in serious trouble with his classwork. Missed homework assignments, this book report. There's a big midterm tomorrow. I know he's not prepared for it. I've got to get to school.
What, are you a child, Mitch?
Get ready for school. You got a test tomorrow. Don't let me down.
So they finally decide that the only way is for Eddie not to get mad or to get legal, but to get even.
But these guys cheated me and now they're trying to collect. They're scum, man.
You know, he's got a good point there. I think it's time we hit these guys where it hurts.
Come on, you with us?
And that's to cheat the cheaters by pulling off the great casino heist.
Well?
I'm thinking.
I think we should stick.
Well, you only live once. Amateurs.
Gina, I know what I'm doing.
Okay, I'm just saying that I think it's a good idea.
Hit me.
Nice to see a complete lack of lifeguarding in this episode.
Honey, it's getting late. What do you think happened to Eddie and 00 Bonehead?
We lose all our cash, they'll write us a marker. Isn't that right?
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, please move to the nearest exit.
The good guys prevail, thanks to Craig for being a dirty rat. While everyone else was trying to fit in.
What? You were wired? Wait, that's why you were standing out there in the hallway risking my life?
That's right. You get all you needed?
You betcha.
By mingling and adding in every gambling pun in the movie Spy Handbook.
We need to talk about your style of doing business.
But first, the rest of the money.
All the money.
What did you decide on?
A Chardonnay, is that all right?
Chardonnay? Perfect.
Toss.